I have just announced in Parliament details of the granting of self-government to the Transkei. The Transkei is the first Bantu homeland which has approached the government of the Republic to aid it by means of this great step on the road to independence, for which in its final form it rightly feels it is not yet ready. My government is prepared to grant the Transkei a new constitution, which will create a parliament and a cabinet of ministers based on the principles of Western democracy. The details of the constitution will be worked out in consultation with the Bantu leaders of the Transkei. This will include the constitution of its parliament and the exercise of the franchise. The Transkei will have a wholly black parliament and cabinet, since the white inhabitants of the Transkei will have no political rights there but in the Republic. This means that the government is willing to grant to the Bantu nations of South Africa the opportunity to work out their own destinies, just like all other states in other parts of Africa and Asia. An enormous program for the development of political self-realization of each national group is therefore being devised. The support already obtained for this program gives the lie to the propaganda that there is a widening chasm between whites and non-whites in South Africa. Despite provocation, criticism, and extremist demands, the Republican government is determined to solve the political problems of the country and its peoples in such a way that stability and tranquility for all is assured. In contrast to the chaos and turbulence elsewhere in Africa, the South African government has refused to allow itself to be provoked to undertake extreme measures in its primary and legitimate function of ensuring law and order. The new South Africa, which is being constructed by the measures announced today, holds within it great promise for the building up of friendship and cooperation between the races. It furthermore guarantees to each the retention of his own identity. All the nations of the world which seek to protect human dignity and the right to self-determination should give South Africa a fair chance to establish and develop its own Commonwealth of Nations.
Chief Matanzima, I presume that you can tell us quite a lot about the possibilities of the Transkei. Say, for instance, in the event of total independence, would you say that the Transkei has the manpower and the talent to run its own affairs?
The Bantu people of the Republic of South Africa are the most developed of all the Bantu states in the continent of Africa. And there is no doubt that there is plenty of manpower for self-determination in the Transkei.
Could you tell us what the future possibilities of the Transkei are?
The Transkei is a country with wonderful resources for its future. We have agriculture, coal deposits, copper deposits, marble, and building of dams. As a sign of development, we have big irrigation schemes now under construction in the St. Mark's district, and factories in the Umtata area. And also, the Tsitsa Falls will provide hydroelectric power stations.
Have you any Bantu at the moment trained as medical doctors and veterinary officers?
There are several Bantu who have qualified as doctors and veterinary officers.
And what about lawyers and magistrates?
The Bantu in the Transkei territories have their own judicial system. They have their magistrates, lawyers, and prosecutors. I'm also a judicial officer.